Hello everybody, Angel Arts here, and welcome to another episode of Gay Let's Play Dragon Age Inquisition Blind. Alright. So we saved the day, we saved Frostback Mountains from the giant rift. It's still there, we closed it, but we didn't get rid of it completely, which is fine. The people seem to be safe for now. And now we're gonna go and speak to Cassandra. Whoa. This was the Chantry. This is where the cult leader was, I think, where we found Brother Jim TV with. So of course we're gonna steal from the Chantry. Of course we are. Acolyte staff blade. Oh. Curved staff grip. Schematics for... That's cool, for creating staffs. That's probably something I might want to use. Fennec fur? Okay. Reed. The Fade. The study of the Fade is as old as humankind. For so long as men have dreamed, we walked its twisting paths, sometimes catching a glimpse of the city at its heart. Always as close as our own thoughts, but impossibly separated from the world, from our world. The Tevinter Imperium once spent vast fortunes of gold, lyrium, and human slaves in an effort to map the terrain of the Fade, an ultimately futile endeavor. Although portions of it belong to powerful spirits, all of the Fade in its constant flux, the Imperium succeeded in finding the disparate and ever-shifting realms of a dozen demon lords, as well as cataloging a few hundred types of spirits, before they were forced to abandon the project.
Have you gone completely mad? He should be taken to Val Royo immediately, to be tried by whomever becomes divine.
Hey, I saved your butt.
I do not believe he is guilty.
The Canary failed, Seeker. The breach is still in the sky. For all you know, he intended it this way.
I do not believe that.
That is not for you to decide. Your duty is to serve the Chantry.
My duty is to serve the principles on which the Chantry was founded, Chancellor, as is yours.
Ooh. Serve the principles. That's what I love about Cassandra when I was talking about her in my character analysis, is that she is a, she likes to abide. She likes to abide by the rules virtually every time, but within reason. You know, if it goes against her core principles, then she's gonna say something. Like, she's not gonna go, you know, not gonna handle that BS due to a technicality. A chant for the departed. The light shall lead her safely through the paths of this world and into the next. For she who trusts in the Maker, fire is her water. As the moth sees light and goes toward flame, she should see fire and go towards light. The veil holds no uncertainty for her, and she will know no fear of death, for the Maker shall be her beacon and her shield, her foundation and her sword. Transfigurations 10:1, often sung by the mourners as they light candles. I was trying to do that in chanter mode. What's in here? Oh. Is there a map for this building? Apparently not. I'm sure they won't mind if I'm snooping around here. Whoa. Whoa! Wow, this place is a lot larger than I thought. Okay. Chantry Hierarchy. The Divine is the titular head of the Chantry, although since the Schism split this Imperial Chantry into its own faction there are now in fact two Divines at any one time. One Divine, informally called the White Divine, is a woman housed in the Grand Cathedral in Val Royo, which I believe was Justinia V. The other, known as the Black Divine, is a man housed in the Argent Spire in Minrathos. Huh. Neither Divine recognizes the existence of the other, really? And the informal names are considered sacrilegious. No matter the gender, a divine is addressed as most holy or your perfection. Beneath the rank of divine is the grand cleric. Each Grand Cleric presides over numerous chantries and represents the highest religious authority for their region. They travel to Val Royeau when the College of Clerics convenes, but otherwise remain where they are assigned. All Grand Clerics are addressed as Your Grace. Hi, Miss Grand Cleric Elthina. Beneath the Grand Cleric is the Mother, or in the Imperial Chantry, the Father. If a mother is in charge of a particular chantry, revered is appended to her title. These are the priests responsible for administering to the spiritual well-being of their flock. A mother or revered mother is addressed as Your Reverence. Brothers and sisters form the rank and file of the chantry and consist of three main groups: Affirmed, Initiates, and Clerics. Affirmed are the lay brethren of the chantry, those regular folk who have turned to the chantry for succor. Often they are people who have led a difficult or irreligious life and have chosen to go into seclusion, or even orphans and similar unfortunates who erased the chantry life. That's what happened with Leliana. The Affirmed take care of the chantry and are in turn afforded a life of quiet contemplation, no questions asked. Only those folk who take vows become initiates. These are men and women in training, whether in academic knowledge or the martial skills of a warrior. All initiates receive an academic education, although only those who seek to become Templars learn how to fight in addition. Clerics are the true academics of the chantry, those men and women who have dedicated themselves to the pursuit of knowledge. They are often found in chantry archives, sages presiding over libraries of books and arcane knowledge. The most senior of these clerics, placed in the charge of such archives, are given the title Elder, although such a rank is still beneath that of Mother. All other brothers and sisters are addressed simply by noting their title before their name, such as Brother Genitivi, from a guide for ambassadors from Avani. It's really cool to review all of these things in the lore. These are all things I pretty much recognize, but I never like really formally read about. Thief Blade, Ferelden, Captain Long. Wow, we've got a lot of stuff here that people left behind that I just rescued. I rescued them. Founding of the Chantry. Cordelius Draken, King of the city-state of Orlais, was a man of uncommon ambition. In the year 15 ancient, the young king began construction of a great temple dedicated to the Maker, and declared that by its completion, he would not only have united the warring city-states of the south, he would have brought Androstrian belief to the world. In 3 ancient, the temple was completed, there, in its heart. Draken knelt before the eternal flame of Andraste and was crowned ruler of the Empire of Orlais. His first act as emperor to declare the chantry as the established Androstinian religion of the empire. It took 3 years and several hundred votes before Arlesa of Montsimard was elected to lead the new chantry. Upon her coronation as divine, she took the name Justinia in honor of the disciple who recorded Andraste's songs. In that moment, the ancient era ended and the divine age began. From Ferelden, Folklore and History by Sister Petrine, Chantry Scholar. Wow. I need a rogue to get me in there. Varric, where are you? I need you and your chest hair, please. Light? Ooh, nice. Varric, I need you here. Potions belt increases the maximum capacity of each non-healing potion by the specified amount. Sure. Yeah, why not? There you go. And equipped by it. There you go. Okay. Life ward. Okay. Yeah, so this is the dungeon. I never really thought that the Chantry would have a dungeon necessarily, but I guess, yeah, I guess that makes sense. Oh, ow, ooh, sorry, Art, ooh. He didn't even flinch, he's such a tough boy. Did I shut the door behind me? Oh well, I don't remember shutting the door. Ooh, well this is nice. What else we have here? The Maker. There was no word for heaven or for earth, for sea or sky. All that existed was silence. Then the voice of the Maker rang out, the first word, and his word became all that might be. Dream and idea, hope and fear, endless possibilities, and from it made his firstborn. And he said to them, in my image I forge you. To you I give dominion over all that exists. By your will may all things be done. In the center of heaven, he called forth a city with towers of gold, streets with music for cobblestones, and banners which flew without wind. There he dwelled, waiting to see the wonders his children would create. The children of the Maker gathered before his golden throne and sang hymns of praise unending, but their songs were the songs of the cobblestones. They shone with the golden light, reflected from the Maker's throne. They held forth the banners that flew on their own, and the voice of the Maker shook the fade. And the voice of the Maker shook the fade, saying, in my image I have wrought my firstborn. You have been given dominion over all that exists. By your will all things are done, yet you do nothing. The realm I have given you is formless, ever-changing. And he knew he had wrought amiss. So the Maker turned from his firstborn and took from the fade a measure of its living flesh and placed it apart from the spirits and spoke to it, saying, here I decree oppositions in all things, for earth, sky, for winter, summer, for darkness, light. By my will alone is balance sundered, and the world give a new life. And no longer was it formless, ever-changing, but held fast, immutable, with words for heaven and for earth, sea and sky. At last did the Maker from the living world make men, immutable as the substance of the earth, with souls made of dream and idea, hope and fear, endless possibilities. Then the Maker said, to you, my secondborn, I grant this gift. In your heart shall burn an unquenchable flame, all-consuming and never satisfied. From the fade I crafted you, and to the fade you shall return. Each night in dreams, that you may always remember me. Huh, that's interesting. I never knew that part. And then the Maker sealed the gates of the golden city, and there he dwelled, waiting to see the wonders his children would create. Canticles of Theranodes 5, verses 1 through 8. This chest I thought I'd be able to unlock with a rogue, but it's not giving me any option to do that. Okay, sorry to keep you guys waiting, but I have one more room to look at. Cassandra. Read. Minave. Enemies drop unique collectibles. Bring them to the researcher to learn more about your foes and earn combat bonuses against them.
I believe Seeker Pentagast was looking for you.
Okay. Turn in research. Shadow Sense removed. Cool.
Please so tell I me get, if you find something.
I get information on them? Research? The children of Andraste. There are many misconceptions regarding Andraste's bloodline, Monsieur. This is due, I should think, to a general lack of knowledge regarding Andraste's mortal life. Understandable, considering the many cults that arose following her death. Everyone sought to claim Our Lady for their own culture, or claimed some aspect of her existence was a lie. All of them complete fabrications. My order has done considerable research to ascertain the truth. We all know Andraste and the Betrayer raised 5 children. The eldest 3 were sons, Isarath, Evirion, and Verald. I didn't know that Andraste had children. I didn't know that. The rule of what was once southern Tevinter was split among them. Isarath was given the west, what today is Orlais. Evirion was given the east, what today is the Free Marches. Verald was given the central Planassine, what is today Novara. What became of these men and their legacies is the stuff of legend, and the majority of claimants to the Andraste's bloodline link back to one of them. None of the 3 sons, however, were born of Andraste. They were born of the Betrayer's concubine, Gilivhan. Okay. See, I never knew about the regions and the sons and all that stuff. People chose to overlook the fact that Andraste came from the Almari tribesmen and that they were barbarians, not the Fereldans we know today. They were savage warriors who took concubines in addition to their wives, and because Andraste was thought to be too weak to bear children, the betrayer took Gilivan to provide him her heirs. Which she did. After her death, the sons were raised as Andraste's own. Later in life, Andraste proved predictions wrong and had two daughters by the betrayer, Ebris and Vivial. So Ebris and Vivial were the women. Is that why women are meant to be the priests, the head clergy in this universe? They were kept out of the public eye and not permitted to marry, though both had consorts. Ebris had but one child, Ali Vimar, who perished on a voyage to Denerim, less than a month after her mother fell to the plague. And without children of her own, the younger daughter, Vivial, was more controversial, a strong-handed woman who defied her family by falling in love with a mage of Tevinter, Regulan. Vivial and Regulan went into self-imposed exile as the Exalted March began, and into hiding following Andraste's betrayal and murder. What became of Vivial and her descendants is largely unknown for one primary reason. She had only daughters. Each of those daughters had only daughters. They married into other families and took other names. Oh, and in the chaos of the Second Blight, all traces of survivors were lost. Andraste's true bloodline, if it exists, lies solely in the descendants of Vivial, and the suspicion of my order is that it produces only daughters. Thus, the claims of your young man, Monsieur, are highly suspect. Oh. From a letter by Sister Galena of the Augustan Order, Dragonite 12. I think that does explain why the high clergy of the Chantry are all women. Makes perfect sense. As opposed to how it's, like, in a lot of, well, Christians, if they do only have males, like Catholicism, you know, only a man can be a priest, and if you want to be a religious, dedicated woman, you'd have to be a nun. A sister.
Chain him! I want him prepared for travel to the capital for trial.
Disregard that, and leave us.
You walk a dangerous line, Seeker.
The breach is stable, but it is still a threat. I will not ignore it.
I did everything I could to close the breach. It almost killed me.
Yet you live. A convenient result insofar as you're concerned.
Have a care, Chancellor. The breach is not the only threat we face.
Love the
Someone
voice acting.
Someone was behind the explosion at the Conclave. Someone most holy did not expect. Perhaps they died with the others, or have allies who yet live.
I am a suspect?
You, and many others.
How the tables
but
have turned.
Not the prisoner.
I heard the voices in the temple. The divine called to him for help.
So his survival, that thing on his hand, all a coincidence.
No.
Providence. The Maker sent him to us in our darkest hour.
Ah. Are you sure? I like the thumbs up. I'm not the chosen one. You believe I'm innocent? It's like, WTF? Really?
You've changed your mind about me, clearly.
I was wrong. Perhaps I still am. I will not, however, pretend you were not exactly what we needed when we needed it.
Conveniently.
The breach remains, and your mark is still our only hope of closing it.
This is not for you to decide.
Ugh,
you know
stab
what
it.
This is, Chance.
Stab it.
A writ from the divine, granting us the authority to act.
Oh, so you probably
As
shouldn't.
Of this
you probably
moment,
shouldn't stab it.
I declare the Inquisition reborn.
Yes.
We will close the breach. We will find those responsible, and we will restore order with or without your approval.
Oh, bless your heart. Bless you, Cassandra. Oh, I love her.
This is the divine's directive. Rebuild the Inquisition of old. Find those who will stand against the chaos.
Perfect.
We aren't ready. We have no leader, no numbers, and now no Chantry support.
But we have no choice. We must act now.
Yeah, we also
With
have no
you
choice.
At our side.
Oh, well. Look, I love how art just towers over the two women, and yet both women are just as large in terms of personality and just sheer strength of personality. Like, he's... Art's kind of overwhelmed. I mean, the reason why he's a little... He doesn't feel like he's this chosen one. He doesn't feel, like, heroic. He just feels like he's just some guy that just happened to be in the right place at the right time, and... But he'll do what he can, you know? He's humble like that. A very humble Canary. Very gentle, humble Canary.
What is the Inquisition of old, exactly?
It preceded the Chantry. People who banded together to restore order in a world gone mad.
After, they laid down their banner and formed the Templar Order, but the Templars have lost their way. We need those who can do what must be done united under a single banner once more.
But aren't you still part of the Chantry?
Is that what you see?
The Chantry will take time to find a new divine, and then it will wait for her direction.
But we cannot wait. So many grand clerics died at the Conclave. No, we are on our own. Perhaps forever.
That sounds a lot like the Grey Warden. So it's just me, you, and me, Al. We don't have any leader. We don't have anyone behind us. We've got this big blight, which is terrorizing the entire Thetis, the entire world. So yeah, good luck with that. This is pretty much feels just as epic. The thing about the Dragon Age 2 storyline that I think a lot of people felt is that compared to the epicness, to the worldwide, to the world, you know, the fact that your warden affected so many, a wider breadth of people instead of just one city, just made that story feel far more epic than it did in Dragon Age 2. The Dragon Age 2 story was a lot more intimate, and, you know, epic versus intimate, you know, you can make your arguments about which one is better. I don't think there's a right or wrong answer to that. But it's just really cool to come back to the, you know, the save the world kind of, you know, from a catastrophic event might seem a little cliche, but come on. We enjoy it. I enjoy it, at least. And I'm just kind of glad to be in the position again. So quickly, I was wondering how they were going to explain having you become at such a high position in the Inquisition so quickly. And the storytelling, everything that's led up to this, makes sense. It makes a lot of sense why they would all of a sudden invite Art into this mission and put so much trust in him. And it just feels really great watching Cassandra, watching Art earn Cassandra's trust when he probably wasn't even, like, inadvertently, by accident. He wasn't necessarily, like, focusing on earning his trust. He was just trying to survive. So.
You're trying to start a holy war.
We are already at war. You are already involved. Its mark is upon you. As to whether the war is holy, that depends on what we discover.
I'm not gonna say, and if I refuse, I don't think Art can't refuse. He feels like, okay, there's something to this mark. Maybe he was there for a reason. Maybe. And if so, I mean, this door is wide open. He might as well walk through it.
If you're truly trying to restore order...
That is the plan.
Help us fix this before it's too late.
Nice. She didn't even flinch. Whew! Oh, so epic. So awesome. And the music. I love the theme of this, the musical theme of this game. Love it. That's what the book was for. Cullen! And Josephine! All our advisors are together. Heck yeah. Okay, that's what the book was for in the Dragon Age 2. Because I was wondering what that book was for. Oh, look, Varric and his chest hair. Yummy. The Templars, and another one going to Redcliffe? Is that I see a windmill, is that Redcliffe? What you up? Oh, Cullen. Alright, I'm not sure. Ooh, Roderick's gonna be trouble. I have a feeling he's gonna be trouble. We're not gonna see the last of him. He's gonna be the Patrice, Sister Patrice of this stories, is what I'm thinking. Oh, this is so amazing. I love... In the snow, this whole backdrop is beautiful. Well done, writers, whoever decided to have the game start here. This has a very... Nice. Ha! Huh. Oh, beautiful! Love it! Love that prologue. Oh, jeez. I was saying, with all the snow, it has a bit of a Skyrim. Has a bit of a Skyrim feel to it. Influence. Oh. Hey, Haven's best and brightest. Speak with the smith, speak with the quartermaster, speak with the apothecary. Okay, I feel like I've run out of time, though. Thanks again, guys, for watching this episode of Gay Let's Play Dragon Age Inquisition. Tune in next time, everybody, and until then, love yourselves and love each other.